good day, Primary 6. This is Teacher Anne once again. And we are going to have a new kingdom to talk about today, and that is Kingdom Animalia. We are already done with Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, and Kingdom Plantae. Okay, so what can you say about Kingdom Animalia? What are the characteristics of animals that you know? Anyone? Can you tell me like 3 characteristics of animals that you know? So if you will say animals has 4 legs, and then that is correct. Okay, some animals, not all, okay, they have 4 legs. If you will say some animals crawl, that is correct. Some animals can fly, that is also correct. Some animals live in water, and that is also correct. Okay, so if you will say some animals breathe through their gills, yeah, and that is correct. If you will say some animals both live in land and water, that is also correct. Okay, so today, let's talk about these animals. Okay, so Kingdom Animalia is the largest of the kingdom. The difference between the plant and animal kingdom is based mainly on the sources of nutrition and the ability to move. So last week, we said that plants cannot move, right? So what is the reason why plants cannot move? Anyone? Okay, plants cannot move because they are rooted on the ground, right? They do not have the feet to walk, but they have roots which is rooted on the ground. That's why they cannot move. All animals can be classified into 2 big groups, and they are the vertebrates and invertebrates. Okay, so we have here 2 big classifications of animals. So what are they? We have vertebrates, and the other one is invertebrates. Okay, first, let's talk about vertebrates. Okay, so here are the classifications of vertebrates. First, we have fish, we have amphibians, we have reptiles, birds, and mammals. And mammals also have different classifications, and they are the marsupials, primates, rodents, cetaceans, seals. Okay, so vertebrate animals are animals with backbone. What is backbone, students? If you say backbones, mi like ha, mi kaduk salang, chaimai. They have bones in their back. Most vertebrates have highly developed nervous system and sense organ. What is nervous system? Pasa talaga? What is nervous system? Labo, pasa. Chay? Chay. Okay, and they have sense organs. We have 5 sense organs. Animals have 5 sense organs. And what are they? Anyone? Who can tell me what are the 5 sense organs? Okay, these 5 sense organs, they are all connected to our nervous system. They're all connected to our brain. Okay, so what are they? Anyone who can tell me what are the 5 sense organs? Okay, so number 1 is we have the eyes, right? Okay, so what are the uses of our eyes, or what is the use of our eye? That is used to see, okay? And then we have nose, okay? So what is the function of the nose? The nose is used to smell, right? And number 3, we have the ear or the ears. So what is the function of the ear? The ear is used to hear. And then number 4, we have the tongue. Do you know what is tongue? Tongue pewa lin. So how do you spell tongue? Okay, how do you spell tongue? That is T T-O-N-G-U-E. Okay, so that is tongue that is used to taste. Okay, that's why you taste whether it's bitter, whether it's sweet, whether it's salty or sour. Okay, and the last one is we have the skin. Skin, skin. Okay, skin that is the outer covering of our body. And this is sense of touch. Okay, so these are the five organs. And these five organs help these animals into their everyday living. Okay, so all of these five sense organs, they're all connected to the nervous system. So therefore, they can react effectively to their surroundings. They are placed in the following five smaller groups that is based on their characteristics. First, we're going to talk about fish. Okay, so let's talk about fish. Okay, so fish live all the time in water. Is it correct? Yes. Okay, so if these fish are on land, what will happen to them? They will die, right? And then next, fish swims using fins and their tails. Okay, so fish, they have fins and they have tails. And these parts of their body helps them to swim. What else? Fish breathe using gills. Gills, pewalaika? Gills, pewalaika? I don't know inside if I pronounce it correct. Okay, breathe using gills. Okay, so if you are going to open, okay, the fish, and then you can see there the gills, the color is red. Why is it? Because there are like millions of capillaries which is located in that gills. Because in that gills, the exchange of gases takes place. And then next, other characteristic, lay egg without shell. That is correct. Fish lays egg without shell. Now, I want you to give me an example of fish that you know. I know the number one that you will tell me is Nemo. Shemai? Okay, Nemo, that is clownfish. Okay, so these are few examples of fish. We have the goby fish. Have you seen a fish like this? Anabas. Planin, shemai ka? We have eel, yeah, in Thailand. Yeah, here in Thailand, there are so many, many planin. Laka. Eel, duwa, I don't know what is this inside. Catfish, yes. So many here, big also, they're also big. Anchovy, yeah, anchovy, you can see this in Thailand. Skatefish, what is this? Snapper, grouper, okay? So these are few examples of fish. Can you tell me any fish that you know? But I want the English name, nah? I don't like the Thai name because teacher cannot understand. Okay, so if you know some examples of fish, okay, please write them in a piece of paper and I'm going to ask you next week. Okay, now let's proceed to the next group of vertebrae, and that is what we call the amphibians. Okay, so what are amphibians? Amphibians are cold blooded vertebrates. Pewalaika, cold blooded pewalaika. You can feel that their body is cold. Okay, so what are the characteristics of amphibians? Number one, amphibians live both land and water. So remember that amphibians, they both live where? On land and water. Next, moss have smooth, moist skin like frogs. Moist, pewalaika, moist is like a little wet. But some have dry and rough skin like toads. Do you know what are toads? Okay, if you do not know this, you open your Google and you can look at the image and then you will know what are toads. And then next, amphibians lay eggs. Okay, they lay eggs, that is true. What else? Adults have lungs for breathing. Mielaika, mipot. Okay. So they use their lungs for breathing. Breathing แปลว่าหายใจ. So they, it's like human, we use our lungs for breathing. What else? But they can also breathe through their skin. Okay, so remember that amphibians, they can breathe through their lungs or through their skin. It depends on what, on which place or which area, okay, they are in. If they are in land or if they are in water. Next, many amphibians have certain poison secreting glands on their skin. So like frogs, they have poison. So what is the use of this poison? The poison is used to protect themselves from predator, right? Yeah, so frogs, they have this poison. What else? Okay, and some other amphibians. Okay, so here are a few examples of amphibians. We have frog. Okay, so have you seen a frog like this? Yellow in color, is a little, yeah, it's a little scary, right? Sicilian, okay, eel, I don't like this. Toad, yeah, this is toad, this salamander and newt. Okay, so these are few examples of amphibians. I want you to write them, just write them in your book, please. Okay, so these few examples, because later on, no, maybe next week, okay, I will give you an activity about the different types of animals or different groups of animals. Okay, please write them in your book here. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, but you have in the book already. You don't have the Sicilian, please include. And toad, you have already, frog, newt, salamander. Okay, so in your book, you include the Sicilian and salamander. Okay, let's proceed to the next, which are the reptiles. Okay, so what are reptiles? Reptiles are air-breathing vertebrates covered in special skin made up of scales. Scales, Pelareka. They have bony plates or a combination of both. So remember that reptiles, they are air-breathing vertebrates. Okay, and their body is covered in special skin that is made of scales. Scales, Pelareka. And then bony plates or a combination of both. So here in your book, there are two characteristics of reptiles. Number one, have dry, scaly skin. Okay, so for reptiles, they have dry and scaly skin. What else? Reptiles lay eggs with soft shells on land. Okay, so be careful if you step on them. There are no shells, so they will like, you're going to smash them easily. Okay, next, here are the few examples of reptiles. So help me read them, please. Number one, we have this skink. Yeah, sometimes there is this skink like visiting my plants there outside my house. Turtle, okay, turtle. Tortoise. So what are the difference between the turtle and tortoise? Turtle lives in water, right? And tortoise, they live on land. But both, this turtle also, they live both on, remember that this turtle both live in land and water. Okay, we have chameleon. So this is chameleon. Gecko. Gecko, แปลว่าอะไรคะ? Gecko แปลว่าตุ๊กแก snake is a reptile lizard yeah this is lizard and crocodile so please let's read one more time we have the skink remember their appearance how do they look like okay skink turtle tortoise chameleon gecko snake lizard and crocodile and these are the few examples of reptiles okay so you can copy them in your book or in notebook. Okay, but for yeah, 6 is last 5. I already sent this PowerPoint presentation into the Swiss. Yeah, you can open it there. Okay, but for rooms 1, 2, 3, and 4, since you have a book, so I didn't send it to the Swiss. You can refer to your book, students. Okay, so these are reptiles. Next, we have birds. Okay, birds, Peoleka. Okay, birds are a group of warm-blooded vertebrates. They have warm-blooded, like human, they have warm-blooded. But for reptiles, they are cold-blooded animals. Okay, for birds, they are warm-blooded vertebrates constituting the class Aves. Okay, so what are the characteristics of birds? Okay, number one, they have feathers. They have wings and beak. Okay, what else? Most of the birds can fly. Okay, remember that most of the birds can fly. Can you give me an example of bird that cannot fly? Can you give me? Anyone? Penguin. Yeah, penguin cannot fly. What else? What do you call that big bird? That run fast. What do you call that bird? Do you know what I'm saying? You know what's that bird? I will not give the name. I will ask you next week. Okay, what else? Birds lay eggs with hard shells in a nest. Yeah, birds, they lay eggs. Okay, so there I have a bamboo plant there in front, and the birds, they made a nest and they lay eggs on there. Okay, in that nest. Okay, so I repeat, birds have feathers, they have wings and beak. What else? Birds can fly. Okay, most, but not. Okay, not all. What else? They lay eggs with hard shells in a nest. Okay, so here are a few examples of birds. It says your birds' vocabulary. Crow. Okay, we have the peacock. What else? Dove, sparrow. Goose, stork, pigeon, turkey. Okay, so these are a few examples. What else? Bald eagle, raven, ostrich. Oh yeah, the one that I'm telling you a while ago, the name is ostrich. Okay, what else? Robin, penguin, blackbird, owl, woodpecker. Okay, so these are a few examples of birds. So which of this group doesn't fly? Which one cannot fly? The ostrich, right? The ostrich cannot fly. The penguin cannot fly. Kemeka? Goose, bindeme? Do they? Yeah, I think, but it's, they can only, they can, yeah, I think. But they don't fly high. Okay, next, turkey. Yeah, turkey, they cannot fly. Okay, now let's go to the last. We have the mammals. Okay, so mammals have a four-chambered heart. I mean to say they have 4 rooms in their heart. So when you go to secondary 2, teacher will be teaching like biology, and we will be studying about the structure of the heart. Yes, okay. Mammals are warm-blooded. Like human, they are warm-blooded. What else? They have hair or they have fur. Fur, what else? They have mammary glands. Okay, what is this mammary glands? This mammary glands, it produces milk for their babies. What else? They give birth to live young. Okay, give birth pa wala ka? Potluck, syempre ka? Okay. So that is mammal. So how, here in your book, there are three characteristics of mammals. So let's read together. That is page 10. Have outer covering of hair or fur. Okay, so the same with this. What else? They give birth to live young, except platypus and anteater. So platypus and anteater, they don't give birth. What else? They feed young with their own milk. So why do they have milk? Because they have this mammary gland. So mammary gland, this is the gland that produces milk for the babies. Okay, so now give me an example of mammal. Okay, so here are a few examples of mammals. So can you read them for me? Or we're going to read together. So we have the badger, bull, donkey, giraffe, leopard, panda bear. What is this? Bat, calf. We have the elephant. We have the goat, lion, pigs. What else? Bear, camel, fawn, gorilla, monkey. What is this? Polar bear, bison, cat, fox, hippopotamus, moose, tiger, cow, coyote, horse, kangaroo, rhinoceros, wolf, raccoon, sheep, zebra, hyena, dog, and deer. Okay, so these are few examples of mammals. So all of these animals, they give birth. Kotlu. Okay, why do they give birth? That is for reproduction. They have to reproduce. Okay, so next week, I'm going to ask you to give your own examples of mammals, your own examples of birds, reptiles, amphibians, and fish. So I want you to prepare your examples of this group of animals. Okay, so now we are already done with the vertebrates and we are going to end our lesson today, but I want you to have an advanced reading on invertebrates. What are invertebrates? Invertebrates, they don't have a backbone. Okay, remember, may mialaka, may mikaduksan lang. What else? Has an internal or external skeleton made of protein glass, limestone, water. Remember, those are not bones. Okay, what else? They are usually small. What else? And over 95% of animals are invertebrates. So there are more invertebrates than vertebrates. So invertebrates are animals without a backbone with more than 1.2 million species. They are the most numerous animals on Earth. Most are small, but they have a variety of body shapes. Okay, example, the jellyfish, hydra, earthworm, centipede, snail, grasshopper, housefly, and butterfly. And these are a few examples of invertebrates. So we were going to talk more on this next week. Okay, and there are few groups of invertebrates. Okay, so I'm not giving you homework this time because I know you have a lot already, but students, to those who didn't pass their work yet about this, please pass them in my line, okay? So, but if you already pass in Swiss, so it's okay for me. So some of you are asking why this activity is 10 points while there's only like 6 items, because some of the numbers has 2 and 4 answers and that makes it 10. Okay, bye everyone. See you again next week.